Ako iskreno proučimo svoj jelovnik, primetit ćemo veliku zastupljenost proizvoda životinskog porekla. Većina ljudi smatra da je to kvalitetna hrana, da su se njihovi preci hranili na isti način i živjeli preko 100 godina. Oni kažu, zašto bismo mi uopšte i menjali način ishrane?
But I want to show you tonight that your great-grandmother and your great-grandfather never ate like you eat.
Ali ću vam večeras pokazati da vaš pradeda i vaša prababa nisu nikada jeli kao vi.
Not because they eat something else.
Ne zato što su jeli nešto drugo.
But because the food has changed.
Nego zato što se hrana promenila.
Now let me tell you from the beginning, I used to love my meat.
A moram da odmah na početku kažem da sam ja voleo svoje meso.
So the same painful road that I'm going to show to you.
Tako da isti taj bolni put koji ću vam pokazati.
Is one that I traveled myself.
Je onaj put kojim sam ja proputovao.
And now looking back, I'm very happy with the changes.
A sada kad gledam unazad, veoma sam srećan zbog promjena.
If you'd seen me 15 years ago,
da ste me sreli pre 15 godina,
I looked quite different.
Izgledao sam baš različito.
And I didn't have half the energy I have now.
I nisam imao ni pola energije koju sad imam.
But let's start our little quest here.
Ali hajde da svoju potragu započnemo ovde.
These are the main cancers in the world.
Ovo su glavni oblici raka u svetu.
In men it's mainly colorectal and prostate cancer.
Dakle, kolorektalni i rak prostate su glavni oblici raka kod muškaraca.
And you see it starts here already at 40 to 45 with the colorectal cancer.
I vidite, ovdje počinje sa 40-45 godina sa kolorektalnim kancerom.
And then once you get to a little bit older, the prostate cancer and the colorectal cancer just shoot up.
I sa starenjem vidite kako ovaj kolorektalni i kancer prostate strašno rastu.
And in the ladies, the picture is similar.
A kod žena je slika slična.
Except of course they don't have prostate, so they have
Naravno,
breast cancer.
Pošto nemaju prostatu, a one imaju rak dojke.
And you can see that even as early as 40, in the 40s, breast cancer starts to become a problem.
I vidite da ovdje u 40. godinama rak dojke počinje da biva ogroman problem.
And in old age, colorectal cancer is the most common.
A onda je najčešći oblik kolorektalni rak u onom staračkom dobu.
So you see, colorectal cancer is a good indicator.
Tako da ovaj kolorektalni rak je dobar pokazatelj.
And colorectal cancer is directly correlated with meat consumption.
A on je u direktnoj vezi sa uzimanjem mesa.
Now the New Zealanders, they think that a chicken is vegetables.
Za Novozelanđane je meso živine, dakle pilići su kao povrće.
So they sit way on top of the hit parade in terms of colorectal cancer.
A oni su po broju oboljevanja od raka na vrhu, sam vrh.
And down there in Africa and Japan you have very little colorectal cancer.
A onda na dnu lestvice su neke afričke zemlje i Japan gdje ima vrlo malo dakle rak 12 palačnog creva i rektuma, to je taj kolorektalni rak.
Now, when you cook meat,
kad kuvate meso,
or fry meat,
ili ga pečete,
then you have these compounds that form.
Onda imate ova jedinjenja koja se formiraju.
They're called heterocyclic amines.
Oni se zovu heterociklični amini ili su to heterociklične kiseline.
But there are also other substances which are carcinogenic like benzopyrenes which form.
Ali i benzopireni su isto kancerogene supstance koje se formiraju tu.
And one piece of meat that is fried,
a jedan pečeni komad mesa,
can have substantially more carcinogen in it than a cigarette, for example.
Može u sebi sadržati mnogo više kancerogenih materija nego čak cigareta.
But of course you also eat anticarcinogens, so this doesn't mean that you would get cancer.
A naravno vi jedete i antikancerogene materije, tako da sad one se bore protiv tog raka koji bi se ovdje izazvao.
But the more of this you eat,
ali što više ovog jedete,
the greater your probability of getting cancer.
Veća je mogućnost, veća je vjerovatnoća da ćete dobiti rak.
Now in the old days they used to eat their fresh garden vegetables from the field.
U stara vremena oni su jeli svoje sveže povrće iz bašte neposredno, tamo su ga brali i s polja ga jeli na svom stolu.
And they used to work a lot, physical labor in the fields and on the farms and whatever.
I oni su mnogo fizički radili, dakle trudili su se na tim zemljoradničkim posjedima da urade što više svojom fizičkom snagom.
But we've become couch potatoes.
A mi smo postali krompiri na kauču, dakle uživamo taj sedelački način života.
And we don't eat those healthy foods together with our fast foods.
Tako da ne jedemo te zdrave namirnice sa ovima koje nisu tako zdrave.
See, this one over here is called A alpha C.
Ovo se zove A alpha C, dakle to jedinjenje.
And one piece of broiled beef will have 651 micrograms of that substance per kilogram.
I jedan komad kuvane govedine ima 651 miligram te supstance, dakle koju smo spomenuli. Vidite u kakvoj koncentraciji.
Chicken will have 180.
Piletina će imati 180.
And the other one that we saw was called IQ. It has nothing to do with your intelligence.
A još jedna supstanca koja se zove IQ i nema nikakve veze sa inteligencijom.
And fish is quite rich in that one.
I u toj supstanci je riba bogata.
So the more you eat, the greater your risk.
I što više toga jedete, veći je vaš rizik.
The same for lymphoma, that's lymphatic cancer.
Dakle, rak limfnih žlezda je isto sa sličnim rizikom.
There's Japan.
Ovdje je Japan na dnu.
And there's New Zealand and the United States on top of the list.
A na vrhu su Sjedinjene Države i Novi Zeland.
This was a study that was done on thousands of people in the United States.
Ovo su studije koje su vršene nad hiljadama ljudi u Sjedinjenim Državama.
And even the World Health Organization wrote a big report on this study.
I čak je Svjetska zdravstvena organizacija izdala jedan obiman izvještaj o ovoj studiji.
Here you have the days per week that you eat meat.
Ovdje imate dane u sedmici u kojima jedete meso.
And if you have meat more than 4 times per week,
i ako imate meso više od 4 puta sedmično,
you will see that your probability of getting diabetes just rockets.
Onda se vaša vjerovatnoća da ćete dobiti šećernu bolest strahovito uvećava.
So if you eat meat 6 times per week,
tako da ako jedete meso 6 puta sedmično,
then you have 4 times the probability of getting diabetes to someone who doesn't.
Imate 4 puta veću verovatnoću da ćete dobiti šećernu bolest nego neko ko ne jede meso.
But all probabilities increase. Prostate cancer, colon cancer, ovarian cancer, all of these increase.
Dakle, sve se ovdje povećava u verovatnoći da ćete dobiti i rak prostate i ovarija i ovih svih drugih oblika raka sa jedenjem mesa.
Now in the old days I used to eat meat 3 times a day.
U stara vremena jeli su meso 3 puta na dan.
So I got there in just 2 days. I was up there in just 2 days.
Ja sam ovdje bio negdje i to sa 2 dana.
Now what I've discussed now is the same thing that grandpa and grandma had to face.
Ovo što smo do sada diskutovali odnosilo se na ono isto što su deda i baka morali da imaju na umu, da se suoče s tim.
But what we're going to talk about now is what they never faced.
A ono sa čim se sad suočavamo jeste ono sa čim se oni nikada nisu morali pozabaviti.
And that's modern animal husbandry.
A to je savremeni način za gajenje životinja za ishranu.
You see, today animals are feed commodities.
Vidite, danas su životinje one koje se upotrebljavaju za hranu.
And I've done research on this in many places.
I ovo sam istraživanje radio na mnogim mestima.
And I'll tell you that even third world countries use these techniques.
I mogu vam reći da zemlje trećeg sveta takođe koriste ove tehnike za gajanje životinja.
So today producing animal food is an exact science.
I način na koji se dobijaju životinje za ljudsku ishranu je postala nauka danas.
And it's profit driven.
I to je nauka koja je pokretana profitom.
And what the animals get to feed,
i kada se razmišlja o tome čime će se hraniti životinje,
is nothing like what they got in the past.
Nije to nalik ničem onom što smo imali u prošlosti.
Today we feed these animals animal protein.
Danas ovim životinjama dajemo životinjske belančevine.
Because the theory is that protein makes them grow quickly.
Jer je teorija da ih ove belančevine životinjskog porekla čine da brzo rastu.
And we try to get the cheapest protein.
I mi želimo da dobijemo najjeftinije belančevine.
So animals are fed carcass meal.
Tako da se životinjama daju uginule druge životinje.
That's all the animals that are rejected at the abattoir.
To su dakle sve one životinje koje su odbijene na klanici, pa se onda melju i daju.
Plus all the offal like the heads and the hooves and the things like that.
I dakle sve ono što otpada kao rogovi, papci i tako dalje, sve to ide u to.
So all the diseased animals are processed and ground down to a meal.
Tako da sve one bolesne životinje koje nisu mogle na klanici da prođu, one sad prolaze proces mlevenja i daju se drugim životinjama kao hrana.
And this forms part of the feed.
I to je naravno deo životinjske ishrane.
In many countries they have trucks that pick up dead animals that have been driven over on the road, dogs and cats.
U mnogim zemljama imaju traktore koji skupljaju one životinje koje su ubijene na autoputevima i onda se one isto melju i dodaju.
And that goes into the feed.
I to sve ulazi u životinjsku hranu.
And of course fish meal is a very prominent feed.
I naravno vrlo važan deo ishrane životinja je ono riblje brašno, el tako to je.
That's the heads and the guts and the fins and the things like that.
Dakle sve one ona peraja, glave i sve ostalo od ribe.
And all the undesirable fishes.
I one neželjene ribe koje su izvađene mrežom, dakle oni su za ishranu.
They're fed bone meal and blood meal.
Dakle, kosti se isto dodaju, krv
and poultry byproduct.
I sa živinarskih farmi sve ono što se inače čisti.
That's a nice word for something that's not quite so nice.
To je sad lepa reč, jel tako, za nešto što baš nije tako lepo.
That's for example the heads and the guts and the feet and the feathers.
Dakle, ono perje i kreste i sve ono što ide, a ne bi se sa farme pojavilo negde u ishrani.
That's dried and ground up and fed back to the chickens.
To se sve osuši, samelje i opet se daje pilićima.
You see, a feather is the same as your fingernail. It's a protein keratin.
Jer istog je materijala, istog je sastava, to pero na piletu, kao i vaš nokat, ima keratonina, dakle ista belančevina.
Of course the chicken can't digest its feather.
Naravno da sada pile ne može da svari svoje pero.
So they help it to digest the feather.
A onda oni pomognu da se to pero svari.
They engineer an enzyme which is added to the food which helps to digest the feather.
Onda se doda jedan enzim koji je izumljen, koji onda pomogne da se to pero ipak svari.
The fact that the chicken bleeds internally from the enzyme, that doesn't really matter.
To što pile sada unutrašnje krvarenje zbog tog enzima, to baš nije tako važno.
Then chicken manure is used a lot as a feed, especially in dairy cattle.
I dakle, ono sve što bi se opralo sa živinarske farme je isto u tom lancu ishrane.
And urea, of course.
Urea.
Because the idea is that the bacteria in the rumen will convert this uric acid back to protein.
Jer je ideja da će tu uričnu kiselinu bakterije u probavi pretvoriti nazad u one korisne kiseline.
And then they even feed petrochemical waste to some animals.
A takođe i petrohemijski nus produkti su dodati ovoj ishrani.
So the animals are getting a lot of animal protein.
Tako da sada životinje dobijaju dosta proteina životinjskog porekla.
Now it's interesting to see that dietary protein increases the production of acid.
I zanimljivo je da ove belančevine životinjskog porekla izazivaju kiselu reakciju.
And this can be neutralized by calcium mobilized from the skeleton.
A ona se može, ta kisela reakcija u varenju se može neutralisati kalcijumom iz kostiju.
And as I said to you, animal protein is going to produce more acid than plant protein.
A kao što sam rekao, proizvodi životinjskog porekla će mnogo više izazvati kiseline, kiselu reakciju, nego alkalnu, bazičnu reakciju.
Let me show you. This is the acid load from food.
Ovde je sada kiselost hrane.
That's in milliequivalents per 100 grams.
Tu je sada milliequivalent za 100 grama porciju.
And you will see that fish produces 7.9.
Vidite da ribe proizvode 7.9 ovu kiselu reakciju.
And bread, which is plant protein, will only produce half of that.
A hleb koji je biljnog porekla proizvešće samo pola.
As soon as you refine it, then it doesn't get so good too.
A čim je brašno, dakle rafinisano, ni ono više nije tako bezazleno 7.
But when it comes to meat, it's 9.5.
A kada se to tiče mesa, onda je 9.5.
And the most acid forming food in the world,
a hrana koja najviše izaziva kiselost na svetu,
is your hard cheese at 23.6. That's a world champion.
Jeste onaj kačkavaj, prevreli, dakle odstajali sir.
Ladies, that's bad news for you.
Dame, za vas su ovo rđave vesti.
All right, osteoporosis is caused by too much dietary protein.
E sad, da se zna da je osteoporoza izazvana, evo to kažu naučni časopisi, s suvišnim belančevinama životinjskog porekla.
And I could show you hundreds of scientific papers on that.
I mogao bih da vam pokažem na stotine naučnih časopisa koji ovo tvrde.
And we did a lot of research on that ourselves.
I mi smo sami na univerzitetu radili ovakva istraživanja.
And which protein is going to do it? Animal or plant protein?
I koji će to, dakle, koje će to belančevine izazvati, biljnog ili životinjskog porekla?
Animal protein.
Životinjskog porekla.
It's just a fact. Don't be angry with me. I can't help it.
To su činjenice. Nemojte biti ljuti na mene. Ja vam tvrdim ono što je stvarnost.
Now, we were involved in a research project some years ago.
Pre nekoliko godina bili smo uključeni u jedan istraživački projekat.
Where farmers were complaining that their sheep got skew legs.
Gde su se farmeri žalili da njihove ovce imaju krive noge.
Now nobody worries about a sheep with skew legs because you're not going to see that in a chop.
Ne bi baš niko voleo da gaji ovce koje imaju krive noge, da sad to neko vidi da ovca posrće zbog krivih nogu.
But if it is a stud ram,
ali ako je to onaj ovan predvodnik stada,
a stud ram, that's a male ram.
Ja, ja.
It costs a lot of money.
On je veoma skup.
And if he comes out walking like this, then he's not going to get a good price.
I ako takav ovan izađe iz tog svog zaklona sa krivim nogama, neće postići dobru cenu.
And of course they were feeding them fish meal and carcass meal and all these things.
Dakle, oni su ih hranili na onaj uobičajeni način, ribljim brašnom i svim onim mrtvim samlevenim
telima. And we said, it's the animal protein.
I mi smo odmah rekli, to su belančine životinjskog porekla.
And they said, you're mad.
A oni su rekli, ma vi ste ludi.
So I said, let's test it.
Ajde da ispitamo, rekao sam ja.
Do you think the government would fund it?
Da li mislite da bi vlada to mogla da podupre sredstvima, da odobri fondove? Ne, ne.
So we funded it ourselves.
Tako da smo mi to iz svojih fondova finansirali.
So we took sheep.
Uzeli smo ovce.
And we took 100 day old lambs.
Uzeli smo jagnjad 100 dana stara.
And we divided them into five groups.
I podelili ih u pet grupa.
And we started to feed them like they should be fed.
I počeli da ih hranimo onako kako bi trebalo da se te životinje hrane.
And like industry feeds them.
I onako kako ih industrija hrani.
So what we did is we took five groups.
Evo šta smo uradili, podelili smo ih u pet grupa.
And the first group got a all plant diet.
I prva grupa je dobila potpuno biljnu hranu,
which had a 12% protein content.
U kojoj je sadržaj bjelančevina bio 12%.
That's what a sheep would get if it goes outside and eats lucerne.
To bi bilo isto kao kad bi ovce same išle na pašu i pronašle detelinu, lucerku.
That's a good old-fashioned grandpa sheep.
To je ona prava dedina ovca koja bi išla da pase sama.
We took that same diet and added 3% animal protein.
Uzeli smo istu tu ovcu, dakle, i dali joj 3% belančevine životinskog porekla.
The next group 5% animal protein.
Sljedećoj grupi 5% belančevina životinjskog
porekla. The next group 8% animal protein.
Sljedećoj grupi 8% belančevina životinjskog
porekla. That brought the total protein to 20%.
I to nam je dovelo sadržaj belančevina do 20%.
Of which just 8% was animal protein.
Od kojih je samo 8% bilo belančevina životinjskog porekla.
Then we took another group and we added 8% plant protein.
A onda smo uzeli drugu grupu i dodali joj 8% biljnih belančevina.
Now some of you might be upset with what you will see.
Možda ćete neki od vas biti rastuženi onim što ćete vidjeti.
Remember, these were the normal farm animals that would have been fed in another way.
To su bile životinje koje bi u stvari bile hranjene na drugi način.
Because industry goes up to 35%.
Zato što industrija daje 35% belančevina životinjskog porekla.
We only went to 20.
Mi smo samo došli do 20.
The more animal this is a 12% plant protein.
Ovde je 12% dakle biljnih belančevina.
The more animal protein we added, the skewer the legs got.
Što smo više belančevina životinjskog porekla dodavali, to su bile krivlje noge.
Why?
Zašto?
Because the animal is growing fast.
Zato što životinja brzo raste.
But the legs are decalcified, so they just bend.
Ali su noge dekalcificirane i onda se samo saviju.
Now there is a 12% Mr. Plant protein sheep.
Ovde je 12%, dakle životinja koja je and how much is from animal source?
Nothing.
Ništa.
This is all plant.
Dakle, ovo je samo na biljnim belančevinama životinja rasla.
Like grandpa's sheep.
Kao dedina ovca.
Yes, it would win a Mr. Legs competition hands down.
Mogla bi da ide na svako takmičenje u pravilnom obliku nogu.
Plus 5%.
Plus 5%.
Look at the deformity coming in the feet.
Pogledajte sada deformitete na ovim papcima.
Starting to bend.
I kako se noge počinju savijati.
8%.
8%.
The sheep is so deformed it cannot walk properly.
Ovo je sada tako deformisana ovca da ne može da hoda kako treba.
Something else that was interesting.
Nešto drugo što je još bilo zanimljivo.
We had to take urine samples and fecal samples every day.
Dakle, uzimali su uzorke mokraće i fecesa svaki dan.
And you know, the only way to take a fecal sample is to put on a glove and take it.
Jedini način da se to obavi bio da stave rukavice i da se uzme feces.
Because you couldn't pick it up the floor because that could have urine on it, you see.
Jer ako uzmete sa poda, onda ćete imati nešto što je imalo i mokraću preko sebe.
You know what was interesting?
I znate što je zanimljivo?
Those that got plant protein,
one koje su imale biljne belančevine,
you climbed in,
popeli ste se,
you said, hello, sheepy,
i kazali ste, ovčice,
turn around, please,
okreni se,
and you took it.
I uzeli ste uzorak.
Then you went to the next one,
otišli ste drugoj,
that got animal protein,
koja je imala životinjsku belančevinu,
and he looked at you like this.
I ona je vas gledala ovako.
If you were trying to take it from the 8% animal protein,
ako ste pokušavali da uzmete uzorak od one koja je imala 8% belančanina životinjskog porekla,
you could never go in alone.
Nikad niste smeli sami da odete.
Because his head came down and he charged.
Zato što bi vas ona samlela, dakle,
napad. The more animal protein they got, the more aggressive they got.
Što su više belančanina životinjskog porekla dobijale, to su bile agresivnije ovce.
So this is what he looked like once he was shorn. He's in a bad shape.
Dakle, evo kako se krive noge u vrlo loš oblik.
When the bone was analyzed,
kada je analizirana kost,
you will see that the more animal protein was added,
što više belančine životinjskog porekla je dodato,
the lower became the calcium to phosphorus ratio in the bone.
Odnos kalcijuma i fosfora se u kosti menjao.
So the legs got skewer and the calcium to phosphorus in the bone became less.
Tako da se kost krivila i smanjivao se procenat kalcijum fosfor u kostima.
Now you'll be interested to know what happened to the 20% 20% comparison.
Sada vas možda zanima šta je u onom upoređenju 20% naspram 20%.
Well, those that received the 8% animal protein,
oni koji su primili 8% belančine životinjskog porekla.
And those that received the 8% added plant protein, so the both 20% total protein.
Dakle, to su one grupe sa 20-20 belančevina, samo što je prva grupa iz izvora životinjskog porekla, a druga biljnog.
Notice that the ones on animal protein lost almost or more than twice the amount of calcium to those on plant protein.
Vidite da su izgubile ove na ovce na životinjskim belančevinama dva put više kalcijuma iz svojih kostiju nego one koje su bile na biljnim belančevinama.
This one really stunned us.
Ono sledeće nas je stvarno zapanjilo.
Bone mineral density.
Gustina kostiju, dakle, i minerali u kostima kako su raspoređeni, to je sledećim istraživanjem
was higher in the animal group than in the plant group.
Kao da su bile tvrđe i punije kosti od onih koje su jele životinjske belančevine.
But of course the animal group had the deformed legs and the plant group didn't.
Ali naravno ove su imale krive noge, deformisane noge, ove koje su uzimale životinjske belančevine.
And the animal group didn't have the calcium that the plant group had in the bones.
A kalcijuma nisu imale one koje su jele životinjske belančevine.
What do they test when you go for a bone test?
Šta u stvari se ispituje kad idete na ispitivanje kostiju?
They test density.
Oni ispituju gustinu materijala kod kostiju.
But density is not a good indicator of how strong your legs are.
Ali gustina materije kosti nije dobar pokazatelj koliko su jake vaše kosti.
So the answer is over here.
Tako da je odgovor ovde.
Bad calcium to phosphorus ratio results from animal protein.
Loš odnos kalcijuma i fosfora potiče iz uzimanja belančevina životinjskog porekla.
Now you will say, but that's a sheep and I'm a human.
A onda ćete reći, ovo je za ovce, a ja sam ljudski stvor.
Sheep are not supposed to eat meat in any case, I understand that.
I ovce ne bi trebalo nikad da uzimaju životinjske belančevine, pretpostavljam, dakle.
So which protein is bad? Plant protein or animal protein?
Dakle, koja je belančevina dobra, životinjska ili biljna?
No doubt, animal protein.
Bez ikakve sumnje biljna.
And here is a publication in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition.
Časopis o kliničkoj ishrani.
And now we're dealing with humans, not sheep.
A sada se bavimo ljudima, ne više ovcama.
Dietary animal to vegetable protein increases the rate of bone loss. So the more animal protein, the more bone loss.
Dakle, iz mlečnih proizvoda belančevine povećavaju gubitak koštane mase osteoporoze.
And those women that ate the most animal protein, in other words a ratio of 3 to 0.17,
one žene koje su koristile veću količinu životinskih belančevina na račun biljnih, dakle 3, 3,17, imale su 4 puta veći rizik preloma kostiju.
So ladies, if you want to avoid osteoporosis, cut out the animal protein.
Tako da dame, ako želite da izbegnete osteoporozu, izbegnite životinjske bjelančevine.
Osteoporosis costs a lot of money.
Osteoporoza košta strahovito mnogo novca.
6 billion DM in Germany when this publication
6 milijardi maraka u Njemačkoj tvrde njihovi časopisi.
And you don't want bones that are full of holes like this one. You want bones.
Ne želite kosti koje su pune rupa kao ove.
And if you want to avoid osteoporosis, you also need exercise and not this kind.
Ako želite da izbegnete osteoporozu, potrebno vam je vežbanje, ali ne ove vrste.
Jedes bisschen Bewegung bringt. Even a little bit of exercise is better than no exercise.
Samo malo vežbanja bolje je nego uopšte ne vežbati, kaže ovaj članak.
So the more animal protein you have, the worse off you are overall in your health.
Tako da što više životinskih bjelančevina imate, to je gore po vas što se tiče kosti.